Welcome to 2021, a full year into the pandemic, and we're still wearing, well, these. But face masks and face shields aren't the only changes we've made to our wardrobe or our personal style. The pandemic has also made us rethink how we buy, where we buy, and what we shop for.
In this episode, we explore the new ways the local luxury fashion retail industry is adapting to the next normal, and how the new work environment is shaping the way people dress for business.
So join us, I'm David Saldana. This is Executive Class.
It's been a year since the pandemic, and though many are slowly returning to the office and planning business trips abroad, most of our days are still spent sheltering in place and working from home. Gosh, even I'm still conducting most of my interviews on Zoom.
Unless you've been vaccinated already, most people prefer remote interviews such as this one. So let me ask the president of SSI, the company with the largest portfolio of luxury lifestyle brands in the country, how their clients have changed their buying habits.
First of all, Anton, thanks so much for granting this interview. Give us an idea of what that's gonna look like for a customer that's emerging out of this pandemic.
In terms of fashion in itself, you know, we're still seeing, at least since reopening, we've been seeing a steady growth when it comes to our accessories, fashion accessories, leather goods and the like, and footwear. But, you know, that said, definitely, and this has been the case, in fact, even pre-pandemic, there is a move to casualization, right? And I think the move to even to casualization was further hastened with the pandemic. And we're seeing that in terms of what people are buying today. There's definitely, you know, a move towards athleisure, comfort, loungewear, and even for work, people are definitely dressing more casually nowadays. I mean, when it comes to footwear, for example, we're selling a lot of sneakers, you know, fashion sneakers.
How customers prefer to purchase has also changed. SSI's e-commerce portal, trunk.ph, was launched last November to simulate the physical shopping experience in a virtual department store environment with separate spaces or shops within shops, customized to appeal to the profile of specific clients. There's Trunk Show for a curated selection of high-end fashion labels, Powder Room for beauty, and Trunk, featuring SSI's wide range of affordable luxury brands. But unlike giant online retailers like Amazon or Lazada, Trunk.ph isn't meant to replace a brick-and-mortar store, rather to complement the customer's shopping journey.
Because as far as we're concerned, there really is no differentiation between physical retail and that of e-commerce retail. No, for us, the store and the e-commerce site is one and the same. It's one customer journey, so to speak, right? And it's just really, as I said, added convenience, providing the customer with the ability to decide how they want to shop. If they want to shop both digitally and physically, they can very well do that. If they want to shop solely digitally, they can do that as well. So we customize the experience based on which shop within trunk.ph you're browsing through. No? But that said, you know, as far as the service is concerned, as the SSI Group being part of the Rustan Group heritage, we take our customer service standards very seriously. That's what we're known for. And the intent is to translate the customer service standards that we have in our stores into our e-commerce business as well.
For that, clients can engage their home concierge service called The Specialist, or opt for a live chat online with a customer service representative.
So it's really a combination of both. And I believe, you know, wholeheartedly that the synergy moving forward, the future of retailing, that synergy between online and physical retail is real.
Call it Retail 3.0, where shopping online comes even closer to actually being there in person.
This is really cool. Indeed, as more luxury shoppers discover the comfort and convenience of virtual shopping from home, retailers are introducing even more features to enhance that experience, one of which, in the case of Versace, is the personal virtual shopping experience. And the great thing is, you're talking to an actual person, a brand expert, not some computer bot or call center agent. So let's try it out.
When the country was first locked down and shops closed indefinitely, the iconic Italian luxury fashion brand, with its store in Solaire, created an online service to reach out to clients, more so for those in need of a new work-from-home wardrobe.
Have you noticed any changes or adjustments to the style, the fit, the cut, even the fabric of the new collections during the pandemic?
Yes, actually for Versace, we are very known for the Barocco print. But how it has changed is that now there are windbreakers. It comes in the different styles. There are windbreakers, there are elastic band, waist-banded shorts or pants. It has become really more comfortable. We have also created more sweatshirts, more t-shirt variations and things like that. So it has definitely evolved from a very high fashion brand to a streetwear brand to a mix of both, which is amazing because then a new Versace customer continues to come back, and the old Versace customer, the more classic one, also keeps coming back.
And because most Versace clients are already familiar with the brand, and the house fit and the sizes, shopping for new items online is much easier than starting from scratch.
So every season, we send a catalog to our customers. It details everything in there from ready-to-wear, accessories, shoes, fine jewelry, foulards, which are our silk scarves. And basically what they do is they can just take a screenshot or input their item code and ask about the price, the sizing, and all of that. They can ask all of the questions to our virtual personal shopper. And if they want to, and if they have about 8 to 10 minimum pieces, we can send all of the items to their house. And they can try it on, and if they don't like anything, they can return it. If they like it, then they can purchase it on the spot. And if they still do want to come to the store, since the boutique is now open to the public, they can choose the item, have it reserved, and come into the store and try it out for themselves. A lot of customers, we realized, still really like to see the fit. They like to feel the material. They like to see how the rest of the collection looks like.
Follow me.
The online experience begins with a tour of the boutique, but not those virtual reality software programs I hate, but an actual physical walk around annotated by your personal shopper.
So here in Ready to Wear, this is all of our entire collection. We tell them this is the collection that we have, this is how we style them, and everything in Versace is styled this way. So it's hung up in this way where it is a suggestive selling experience. We have the top, bottom, bottom, top. Usually there's a jacket also. And we bring them all the items that we think that they will wear.
Sure, any store assistant with an online connection can do the same. But at Versace, you also get expert styling advice.
Since everybody is on Zoom now, everybody has been asking me the same question. First, since you're always sitting down, I would recommend the new Versace waistband shorts. So it comes with a new waistband that's elastic, so you can sit down, walk around, it's really comfortable. Aside from that, we have so many different sweatshirts that don't look like sweatshirts. You know, it's not your typical sweatshirt. It has embroidery or it has a lot of bedazzlement in it. I'm not sure if that's your thing, but it's a very Versace thing, actually, right now.
Okay, not exactly on top of my list, but hey, I'm open-minded. Now, what about the ladies?
A lot of our female customers have also gone into buying sweatshirts. Before, sweatshirts were not a thing. They were not a Versace staple. You don't come to Versace to buy a sweatshirt, right? But now, since
especially
there are so many
ladies,
offerings,
yeah.
Exactly, especially not for ladies, but now since there are so many opportunities for you to stay at home and be more comfortable. We also find ladies buying what I'm wearing right now, which is a foulard, which is basically a silk scarf. And it's something you can wear on Zoom because it's, since it, everything is from the waist up.
Companies like Versace and SSI understand that though a vaccine is now within reach, retail may not return to the pre-pandemic days. Instead, hybrid virtual and in-store shopping model may be the next normal. But don't count out brick-and-mortar stores just yet.
Thank you. Thank you. Virtual shopping may be more convenient, it's definitely more comfortable, but sometimes you just have to visit the physical store, especially when you're shopping for a big ticket item, like a luxury watch.
Although watch retailers like Lucerne are seeing promising online sales, requests for private viewing and by appointment shopping are increasingly popular with VIP clients. If required, the entire boutique can even be closed to accommodate safety-conscious customers.
Most watch retailers offer online shopping, but if you're looking for something as rare as this Vacheron Constantin perpetual calendar, a grand complication that costs upwards of 4 million pesos, you probably want to take a look at it first, right? And hold it in your hand and on your wrist. Big difference looking at it in person and touching it, feeling it, how it balances on your wrist compared to just browsing online. It's two very different things.
Luxury watch buyers actually do both. They research online before deciding to visit a boutique. Sure, there's a lot more I can learn about this ultra-thin overseas perpetual calendar in the brand's website, like that it's only 8.1 millimeters thin, or that the in-house movement has exactly 276 parts. I could even view extreme close-ups of the dial. But shopping for watches like these isn't like speed dating on Tinder. You really need to hold these first in person.
Wow, this is really beautiful and rather light and slim for a grand complication piece. And the only way to appreciate this is to see it up close, not on a computer screen. No way.
Protecting yourself from COVID isn't the only reason for shopping in private. So too is shielding yourself from the prying eyes and gossip of others.
If you're purchasing a watch like this, you probably don't want anyone seeing you buying it, right? That's one of the reasons why you want to have the store closed down just for you.
Yet another reason for visiting a boutique these days is making sure you're getting the real deal and not some high-quality replica online. They make really good counterfeit Rolex watches these days, so protect yourself from internet scams this way. Indeed, online retail is here to stay and expected to further accelerate. But high luxury isn't anything like fast fashion. After all, luxury customers demand much more than just speed and convenience, but the highest levels of personalized service as well.